ASEAN and India continue to be the main drivers of global growth. ASEAN is projected to grow above 5%. India's GDP is predicted to grow at 7.3% in the fiscal year 2018-2019, and average 7.5% in 2019 and 2020. India continues to be the fastest growing major economy in the world, poised to become a US dollars 5 trillion economy by 2025. ASEAN has emerged as the second largest trading partner for India in 2017-18, with a share of almost 11% in India's overall trade.
Lao government support promotion of trade and investment between ASEAN and India. I do hope that Indian businessmen will seek this opportunity for doing their business in Laos.
ASEAN has grown tremendously, and with 642 million population, ASEAN has the third largest market in the world behind China and India. Whilst in terms of economic performance, ASEAN is the sixth largest economy in the world and the third largest in Asia.
ASEAN and India are among the most dynamic economies in the world. Together, ASEAN and India comprise a market of almost 1.8 billion people and have a combined GDP of $3.8 trillion. Since 2010, trade between India and ASEAN has grown by approximately 44%, from $56 billion in 2010 to more than $80 billion today.
Comprehensive integration between ASEAN and India is not only reflected in the increasing free flow of goods, services, and capital, but also in people-to-people contact, physical connectivity, and exchanges in culture, education, and other spiritual values.
This Indian ASEAN Expo Summit offers us another platform to strengthen our existing cooperation and unearth the untapped economic potential between ASEAN and India. This event is also a catalyst that will help us to realize a trade target of $200 billion by 2020.
This year's theme of co-creating the future is highly relevant given today's global dynamic where cooperation is more urgently needed. Our people are connected by deep culture and historical connection, and moving forward by shared vision to live in an open, stable, and secure environment. Together, our region have a hand in co-creating a future that is prosperous, sustainable, and inclusive for our people.
That bilateral trade volume between India and Cambodia reached 126 million in 2017, while investment around 20 million that year, small but growing, which still have potential and opportunities to further improve and nurture.
Under the lead of Minister Suresh and my ASEAN colleagues, I trust our relations will go even stronger.
It is a good ground for the implementation of India's ethics policy working together with ASEAN region.
India-ASEAN represent fast-moving economies. The global headwinds have caused a softening of the global growth from 3.1% to 3% in 2019. ASEAN has emerged as one of the second largest trade partners in India, with a share of 10.58% of India's overall trade. Our bilateral trade has grown more than threefold, from $21 billion to $81.33 billion in the last few years. I believe there is an immense scope for mutual collaboration in services like healthcare, education, tourism, financial services, digital and artificial intelligence. Let us work together and co-create a common future.
We shall explore synergy in agriculture and blue economy, e-commerce and digital trade, means to integrate logistics for regional value chains, deepening trade and investment, and discuss mechanisms to overcome technical barriers to trade. Today, on behalf of the Indian industry and my role as the President of FICCI, I reaffirm our commitment to join hands with our partners in ASEAN to realize the shared dream of peace, prosperity, and economic progress for our nations and our people.
Both India and ASEAN should make maximum use of favorable domestic and global economic conditions to expand their trade and investment relations.
I would like to use this platform to first condemn the Gaysham cowardly terrorist attack in Pulwama, Jammu and Kashmir on 14 February 2019 on our brave security forces. Friends, an environment of peace and security are prerequisites for trade and commerce to flourish. ASEAN-India relations are firmly embedded in culture, commerce, and connectivity.
On behalf of the Indian industry, we reaffirm our commitment towards this tremendous endeavor and to strengthening the economic pillar of engagement between the ASEAN and India, not just through commerce, but also through organic investments, through technology partnerships, through contributions in development, sustainability, and in the soft power that India has in the field of education, healthcare, and medicine, which have been time and again proven to be one of the harbingers of the future of cooperation and collaboration.